Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. My name is Marshay, and today's video is going to be something that I wanted to discuss. I was thinking about it while at work. Of course, I'm working, but you know me at work. I'm like, okay, this is cool, but this ain't what I really want to take down. This ain't what I really want to do. Like in my head, I'm thinking of so much more. So what I really wanted to talk about was how I feel people that you are close to, or may not even be close to, or may have been close to at some point, or who knew you or should know you well, and they question your integrity. That is one of the things that I really, really can't take. Like me personally, I feel like, I mean, I can take it, but I can't continue to like have that relationship on the same level, because I'll look at you and I'll look at the situation and I'll think, if you think that that's how I would think, if you think that's how I would move in that situation, if you think that's who I am, and I'm thinking of people specifically, of course, whenever I come on here, yes, people might be like, oh my gosh, people just, even with my book, pure example, people may think, oh, you just told, you know, your family business, or you may have said all these bad things about people, or they may feel like you have outed people, or you said things that, you know, they don't agree with because of how they view that person, or how they see people, or how they experience people. But it's like, this is my experience as a child. When I tell you I was not even a grown woman writing most of those poems, I was 10, 11, 12 years old, 13 years old, 14 years old, 15 years old. And for the longest, even now, like I'm 28 and I don't write nowhere near as much as I used to. I had more time on my hands. I would go to school and then I would have time, or I would be at school and my mind would be racing with all of these poems and ideas and thoughts and stories that I would write at a young age. And I don't know what happened, but over time that began to decrease, or my time, my availability to be able to think and write my experiences down in that level creatively have slowly dwindled away. Just like I feel like a lot of my ambition, like I was a very ambitious person. I was a person who was driven, who wanted a lot, who wanted to do a lot, see a lot, which I still am. But to some degree, like having a son, having a child, I saw a lot of people say, you know, when they had their child, it motivated them to go hard. It motivated them to do this. And I'm not saying me having my child motivated me not to go hard, but I just feel like I always thought I would go hard, grind, have everything set up for when I had a child. So maybe me having my child and me actually wanting to spend the amount of time I do want to spend with him and do things with him, I feel less of a grind. Like at first I had a hustle mentality, where it was anything I could do to make some money, I'm willing to do it. Anything that I do well, or I can do easy, or that I can do and it not be too much on me, like I would do. Even if it was a lot on me and I was tired and it was taxing, I would do things, and I would do 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. Like throughout a day, I would be doing this and I would be doing that and I would be doing this and I would be doing that. And it would be no stop unless I was laying down asleep, like literally, or maybe getting a second to watch TV. But I didn't have a lot of downtime. I didn't have a lot of time or years where I partied or I played. I was always like working, even in school. Like, yes, I just went to regular general high school, never really went to college except for med tech, just for a program for a year and a half for medical assistant. But outside of that, even in school, it's like I'm constantly thinking. I'm reading at lunchtime. I'm constantly doing my homework before I get home, because when I got home, I did want that time like to be able to play. Me and my cousin did play, like in elementary school, at least play outside, play with each other, etc. But I just feel like a lot of the grind mentality, hustle mentality, kind of just made for me as well, because normally it would be, I'm ready to grind. How can I hustle? How can I make a dollar? How can I do this? Yes, I'm thinking about that, but now I'm thinking about it. How can I make it convenient where me and my son are still able to do what we want to do, go where we want to go, be able to have fun, enjoy ourselves, and I still make money? Like, I want to make money from home. I don't want to be able to, I don't want to have to be one location for a certain period of time, or be at this location right after, or hustle on the weekend, still working to where we have no freedom or no fun time. That's just the way I view things right now. Like, I may change, it may change anything, but before having a child, I was this grinder, this hustler mentality. People would always be like, you work so hard, or you always do this. And a lot of people who don't know what I do just would be like, you know, they don't know much about me, because I'm like a quiet, reserved, stay to myself type of person, and I don't do too much talking. So people don't really know what I do, how I do. I'm not posting my personal life all on social media. Like, if it ain't about my books, my brands, or my businesses, or me and my son out having fun and enjoying ourselves, you won't really know where I work or what I do. I'm not that type of person, never really did. that thing, like promoting those type of things for my own reasons. And so, but my main reason of coming on here was not to say that. That was part of my truth. But my main reason for coming on here was like, I just don't like when people question your integrity, if they're supposed to know who you are. If you're supposed to know my character, if you're supposed to know who I am, there's certain things you should know that it was no way I did, would do, or that would be in my spectrum of who I am. And when you are easy to believe something about me, or you're easy to say something and be like, well, you do it for this, or this is why you did this, or this is why you do that, then it's quick for me to just be like, you know what? That's why I can't deal, because I know me. I know who I am. Like I said 1,000 times, like I'm very sure of myself. I may not know exactly my path all the way, but I know a lot of things that are my character traits, who I am, what I wouldn't do, what I would do. And a lot of people don't know me. They don't know me well. And of course I come on here and I make these videos, because like I said, this is like my new diary. This is my new journaling, without me putting names and all that. Because in my journal, my diary, sometimes I put, you know, actual names. But for this, I just come on here, tell a little story, or tell my experiences or what I'm thinking and feeling, because maybe someone can relate. But it's just like, if you question my integrity on certain things, you don't know who I am, my character, you don't know, like, nah, she would never do that, she's really this type of person, then you don't feel like I'm solid. I can't mess with you, because like, I'm such a Taurus. I don't know, I just feel like that's a Taurus trait. Like, I'm such a Taurus, I'm such a solid person, where we feel like you even ride for us. It reminds me of Candy. This is one of the reasons I really, really like Candy on Real Housewives of Atlanta, and she's a singer from Escape and the whole nine. The reason I really, really like Candy, outside of the fact that she's this big hustler grinder, she's gonna go for her dreams, she's gonna go for it all whether you believe she does it well or not. But another reason I really love Candy, she's close to her family, she has her children, her husband. I feel like I love all of that. But one of the biggest things I love about her is the fact that she has her loyal group, her loyal circle, her loyal team that she sticks with, that she sticks by. And if you don't like one of them, then for the most part, she doesn't like you. And I know some people don't have that mentality. Some people feel like, well, that don't have nothing to do with me, or I can still be cool with this person, I can do this, or I can do that. Me, I'm so not like that. I'm so loyal. I'm so black and white. To me, I consider this loyalty. To me, I consider it, I'm very black or white. I'm not like a in-between person of like, oh, hey, it's however you want to do it, however you want to move. No, I'm the type of person where to me, it's either you're on that team or you're on that team. And unless it's your personal, say it's your kids. Okay, no, I'm not on neither one of y'all team. I'm on both of y'all team. I'm riding for both of y'all. That's different. Say it's your parents or grandparents or something like that. Okay, yeah, you ride for both of their team. But I'm talking about people that are outside of your immediate family circle, and they are still close to you, or even in your immediate family circle going against someone else. It's no way you should ever be like finicky, or they don't know which side you're on, which team you play for. I always used to joke and say this. I'd be like, you gotta know which team you play for. And I mean that wholeheartedly, because maybe it's just who I am, maybe it's how I like to live, but I like to know which team I play for, and I like people around me to know which team they play for. And if you don't know which team you play for, which side you're on, you know, you're kind of like, I love you, I kind of like you, but hey, I'ma still do this with her, and I'ma still agree with this. I can't really ride with you like that. That's why I'm so quiet. That's why I'm so to myself, because the type of person I am, I'm going to go hard for those that go hard for me. If you really, really on my side, we really, really are supporting each other, loving each other, and it's nothing you can say or do that would make me go against you, against someone else, for the most part, then I would feel like it should be that same way for me. And when it's not, it's like, oh no. See, the way I am, it's like, oh no, I can't be cool with you. I can't be cool with you, because it's like, what are you doing? You're playing for both sides. You know this person did something completely wrong as a human being, or as a person, or whatever you want to call it. And then you still like riding the fence, riding the line. You don't know if you're on that side, this side, their side, both sides. Like, that ain't me. I don't know. I'm just too solid for that. I don't know. I just feel like that's how I am. I'm very solid. I pick my side and I stand by it. And if I don't really like you that much, well, that's on you. I'm sorry, but I am like that. Like, it's certain people who I just don't like that much. And it's certain people who I really, really like. And then it's just, and it's not that I'm harsh or anything or insensitive, because I can have a heart for everybody. The type of person I am, people don't know it because they don't really have that deep conversation with me or really, really talk to me on no type of level. But I can have a heart for everybody. I could care for so many people. I could have love for so many people, love so many people. And it's like, I could see where you're coming from, why you are the way you are and all that. But even with me knowing why you are the way you are, it's certain parts of me that's just like, well, if I can't mess with that created you to be like that, and now I can't mess with who that created, that's how I am. I'm like, I understand why you are the way you are, but that still doesn't excuse it. It still doesn't make me feel like, okay, well, I understand why you are the way you are, so it's cool. Nah, if I don't agree with like certain things, certain behaviors, I'm not gonna go for it. That's just who I am. But yeah, if you haven't checked out any of my Car Chronicles, go back and watch them all. I think at this point, this is probably like Car Chronicle 25. I've done so many videos in such a short span. Maybe because, like I said, I'm going to a 9-to-5 every day and I got nothing else to do but come on here and talk. And so there's a lot of Car Chronicle videos. And at first I was numbering them, and then it got kind of mixy in the middle, and I had to go back and renumber them and rename them, which I'm still trying to upload some of them. I think there's at least like 6 of them still sitting in my phone. Like, this will be number 7 still in my phone that has to be uploaded. Because again, I'm just doing this all from like my phone when I get home, trying to upload these videos. Some days I don't even remember. I'm so like into spending time with my child. But I say that to say, you know, be sure to pick a side, pick a team. I mean, you don't have to when it comes to certain things in life. Maybe that's not who you are, but maybe it's just who I am. I just feel like being solid really matters. I'm not the type of person that goes against people I love or I care about. And I don't put on shows for people. I'm not going to fake be on your side 1 minute, on this side the next minute, like I'm a tourist. Like, we either love you or we don't. We either chose you or we don't. We haven't chosen you. And so it's like, yeah. And then it's like, if you play finicky with me, then I play finicky with you. Like, I'm cordial, cool with you, but I'm not really on your side. Me, I'm not a finicky person. Like, the people I'm used to dealing with, I don't know, I don't really deal with finicky people, except for like, if I think about anybody being finicky and I'm choosing them, like, I always have a circle, whether it's with the kids, whether it's with my family, whether it's with my sister, my brother. Like, it's certain people that I choose. We chose each other, and it's like, we're on each other's side. But when it comes to like men, that's the thing I can't say, is like, with men, it's very finicky. I don't even know what I think at this point. Like, one point I started off where it was like, I went through so many different phases. I'm 28 now, right? I went through one phase being a young child. Was like, I want to get married. I want to be with one man. I want to have this ideal life, relationship, all of that, right? I ain't gonna tell y'all this other phase. I went through this other phase, right? Where I was like, you know what? These men are terrible. They all do the same thing. They all cheat. And this is before ever being cheated on. Let me tell you that. Because I know people like to get confused and they like to be in my business. They don't even know my situations. Don't even know my relationship. Not even trying to be funny. But the very few people that think they know my business or know my relationship or situations, they like to feel like, oh, this is why she feels like that. No. Before ever getting cheated on myself. Because I've been in very, very few relationships. I've been in very, very few situationships, whatever you want to call those things. But before ever being in a relationship, before ever being cheated on, me knowing it for 100% facts or whatever. I don't know if I was cheated on and didn't know it. But I'm talking about before ever being cheated on and me knowing it 100% facts, I still went to a phase before, like, having my child, all of that, where I was like, I don't know. Men are so finicky. They do these women dirty. They dog women out. They don't treat women well. Like, I just never seen a man really, like, exemplify this behavior. So for me, it was always scary when I thought about relationships, when I thought about how men treat women, when I thought about how men interact with women. And it always scared me. It always made me feel like, I don't know if I even want to be in a relationship once I got grown and saw. Like, being a child, I had this ideal world in my head of what I wanted. Once I was like 18, I don't even think I was really talking to people. It's like, I was talking to people in high school, being cool, having little friends, texting, talking, nothing serious, right? Then it's like, I get 21, that's when I really started like actually being in relationships or situations or whatever. But it's like, I, even before ever doing that, I already, by the time I started getting, before being 21, it was like, I didn't even trust men. I already thought that, you know, you can't trust them. They all cheat. They all dirt. Like, they just don't do right by women. I just felt like that, right? And I never really saw a woman just, like, really feel happy about the relationship she was in, love the man she was with genuinely. Not put on a show, not fake and be like, yeah, he this, or cover up for him or fake. Like, honestly feel like that. I never really seen it. So this is what I thought. By the time I got older, I was like, oh no. Like, I still want to save myself for marriage and everything. I still don't want to be just doing anything with anybody. But then it was just like, I don't know how this relationship gonna go. So if I get in a relationship, maybe I'll, you know, like, maybe I was even considering thinking, like, dang, maybe I need to have an open relationship to some degree. Not open where you, like, mess with 1,000 people. But I'm like, dang, I don't know what type of relationships, like, are real and really exist. And so now, even at 28, after being through my own situations now, having my own child, getting older, having a few experiences myself, it's just like, I don't know what I think about relationships. I'm still learning. I'm still trying to ask God. I'm still trying to get clarity. I'm still trying to find peace with it, because I know who I am. Like, I'm really, I want to say to some degree or extent, reserved or conservative when it comes to, I'm not willing to be a hub. I'm just not. Like, I know how we glorify certain behaviors, certain relationships. We glorify, you know, women go out here, do what you want, how you want, when you want. Now, I might think of some whole things, but I'm telling you, I just personally, I got too many fears to be walking around being a hoe, like being a whore. I just can't do it. Like, it ain't in me. I ain't built for that. Like, I'm not built to be doing too much. Like, I'm just not. And so, and then morally, I just would feel guilty and all that. Like, I done had my moments, don't get me wrong, being young, 21, like, probably talking to this person, talking to that person, but I never passed, like, talking to two people or something. Like, I don't think. Let me make sure I ain't lying, but I don't think, like, I ever just was like, oh, let me talk to a whole roster. Now, I do remember my best friend joking about, oh, you got your star five lineup, but I don't think I was, like, talking to all them at the same time. I don't know. I might have at some point, but it's just like, you know, never really taking this serious. That's what I'm saying. Actually having sex with these people or nothing like that. So if it was to ever get to that point, I don't think I could just do it, like, with multiple people, be around doing here, anything, living my life, being single. That's not me. So it's just like, what kind of relationship can you have in 2023 where it's healthy, happy, you and this person love each other, choose each other, and still be able to build a life, build a family together, and be happy genuinely, and not put on a show, not, oh, we love each other, we choosing each other, but we cheat on each other. Like, is that supposed to be normalized? I don't get it. Like, and I'm not even the biggest person that's against cheating. I used to always say, and I know this is bad, I used to always be like, what did I used to say? Like, I'm not even against cheating. Like, cheating is so normalized around me that I thought that, like that's a part of it. Like, that's a part of the game. I wasn't even 100% against cheating. My thing is about, like, disrespectful. Like, disrespect is bad. And going too far with disrespectful cheating is bad. And, like, that's when it gets bad. Like, and if you just don't even love or care about the person you with, but you want to cheat, 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 go have fun somewhere else. That's what I feel like is bad. But, you know, I didn't used to always 100% be against cheating once I became grown, because I was just like, everybody does it. Everybody's doing it. So what is going on? Like, are people really in happy relationships? Like, do they really love their partner, choose only their partner, no one else? Like, I just don't know how that goes. And I never seen somebody just, like, really, I don't know, be together for a long period of time since young, not cheat on the person, not be messing with other people, or break up for a period of time and go back together. Most of the people I know that were in long-term relationships, it was either not really claiming it, acting like they're just friends, or break up and get back together, or, you know, partially be together, but not really, really 100%. I'm committed to you, you're committed to me, we build a family, we have whatever. So I don't know how that goes. I need clarity. Like, is it real? That's why I be watching so many podcasts, so many shows, listening to these marriages. And even with listening to that, I'm learning things about people's marriages. Never knew, you know, like with Tamela Mann and David Mann, he had a child that she found about while. Now, he had the child before her, but he did not know, I don't believe, and she did not know about the child until they came to the doorstep while them two were together. And someone brought up the whole thing about, hey, this is your child or whatever. But my whole thing with that is just like, wow, like, if I'm scared of something like that, like, that's a lot. Like, if you gotta go through that, I'm just like, dang, like, to really be in a relationship, you gotta go through something extreme. Like, I didn't hear them all. I'm listening to all these stories. Oh, either he already had a girlfriend and then they messed with you and they messed with him. And if it's all of that, god dang, you might as well, like, what should you do? Like, it just don't seem good. Like, that don't sound good to me. Like, dang, like, or we were young and at some point, you know, they were going to cheat. That's different. We're together 50 years. Okay, cool. But then, boom, something else happened 30 years later. It's just like, dang, like, what really is a healthy, happy relationship? That's what I'm trying to figure out, because I haven't had it for myself. I haven't had one where it felt like this is us. We are choosing each other. Nothing else going on. This is what we're going to do. This is what we did. This is what we're building. And it worked out for a long period of time. Like, how does that work? That's what I'm trying to see. Somebody tell me, if you've been in this great, long, happy relationship where you didn't never break up, didn't never end, or some big dramatic thing happened where, like, you found out they had another child, or they cheated on you, even if they cheated 20 years ago, or they cheated 10 years ago, or they cheated 3 years ago, or, you know, you cheated on them, or you broke up with them at some point and got back with them. Even Beyonce and Jay-Z cheated and broke up and got back together. I'm just like trying to see or think of any examples. Even one of my favorite couples, Kadeem and Deval Ellis. I really, really like them, because I really don't really look up or idealize no couple. But like, they're a cute, young, fun, happy, family building, beautiful couple. But at some point, I think they both had cheated in some way. I don't want to get their story wrong, but I think that's what they said, like watching the interviews or whatever, whether it was sexual or not, because I don't believe it was sexual on her part, but I don't know. But, you know, I'm just like, can you have a happy, healthy relationship for a long period of time? This is my question. Without any life-changing events happening where either this person has a child, cheats, you know, things that people normally look at as big no-goes in relationship, or what you call that, like, that's a deal breaker. Can you have a happy, healthy relationship for over 10 years, 20 years, 15 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years without a big deal breaker being in the relationship? Say the person, I don't know, loses a limb for 50 years, or goes to jail for 20, or like, I don't know. Is that possible? That's what I'm trying to figure out, because all the examples I'm hearing and seeing, I don't have nobody to talk to me. I don't have nobody that's honest, open, that been in a healthy, happy relationship, healthy, happy relationship, who can say, yeah, well, you're going to go through a period where something tumultuous is going to happen, but this is how you stick through it, or this is when you know to continue on. Because I'm like, how do you know if you should stay in that relationship if it's like that, or how do you know when you should leave? That's what I'm asking. I know people are going to say you're going to feel it, but I'm saying, if you feel like this is your person, you love each other, y'all chose each other, and it just tells you like, hey, my husband isn't a bad person, stick through. Is that what goes on? Like, I'm really confused. I don't know, but if you know, let me know. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. This is Marshay with Marshay, and as always, I'll be back.